guess what makes me different as a speaker is I like to combine different elements. So I like to provide high energy, humor, practical content, all wrapped into an experience for the participants that they can walk away knowing that they just experienced something truly unforgettable.
How many people have ever been to a boring presentation?
Okay. What made the presentation boring?
The speaker, what about the speaker? Monotone, what else?
Lack of energy.
I guarantee to you today that this presentation will not be named among the things you just stated.
Now, there are usually two types of speakers. There's one type of speaker that's like, woo, woo, woo! And the whole audience is like, oh my gosh, this is the best thing I've ever been to. And then we go back to our workplaces, we go back to our home, and we realize we learn absolutely nothing.
Then we've heard other types of speakers that, I mean, have amazing content, content that can change the course of our lives and our work lives.
But after 5 or 10 minutes, they've lost every single one of us.
But what I'm going to give you is a balance of both. See, because I'm going to give you some amazing energy. That's very hard.
But then also some practical content that we can walk out of here and use today.
But what I want you to do, I'm gonna actually have you get involved in this presentation.
What I'd like you to do is the person next to you, I just want you to give them a big hug. It's okay, you can give them a hug. Give them a big hug.
Justin was able to speak about helping individuals to find their core purpose and their passion. And he was able to do that in a way that resonated with the audience. It was clear, it was energetic. He spoke to not only our minds, but our hearts.
I believe humor is important in presentation because part of my philosophy is that if people are enjoying themselves and having fun, that they actually learn a lot more. So I try to incorporate funny stories and different thoughts that really draw people into a great learning experience.
I want you to turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, you look good tonight, but not as good as me. The sad part is that some of y'all really meant that. You looked over like, yeah, you definitely don't look better than me.
The drivers are saying to the amiables, you know, would you just leave me alone? And the amiables are saying, can't we all just get along? And the expressives are saying to the analytics, won't you just say something? And the analytics are saying to the expressives, won't you just shut up?
He said procrastination is not the problem, it's a symptom. And I was like, wait a minute, what? He's like, this is not a problem, it's a symptom. Because there's things that you don't procrastinate on. If you think about it in your life, aren't there things you don't procrastinate on? Some of y'all are like, I want to get my check. A friend said they have money for you, right? I'm on my way. Now this is how we start off, y'all. We start off as little babies and we are enjoying our life. We're like, yes, I'm an individual. You know? Yes. I'm an individual. I have my thoughts to my own beat. But what happens? So we come elementary school and then middle school. Some of us high school. Some of us college. Some of us beyond, some of us the rec centers, some of us our families, and this is what happens as we start to encounter many and many more and more people. This is what happens. We end up becoming copies.
Tonight was great. Justin was great. I was expecting one of the normal boring presentations, and it was just full of energy. He was jumping around the whole time, just opening my mind and my eyes to what diversity really means. You know, I had this mindset of what I thought diversity was, and I left tonight with a completely different opinion about things.
I try to provide a presentation that's jam-packed with information that people can actually walk away and put into practice. They can apply action to their everyday lives. And so it's a combination of both kind of inspiration to do something great as well as practical content in order to actually do it.
Because what I realized working within corporate America, diversity of thought captures diversity. So we have people that think different. Even if you came from the same country, are there people who think differently than you? The herd theory states that when danger or something is coming, that a group, the herd, will all go in the same direction. Even if it's off a cliff.
The question for us is, where is our herd leading us?
Don't be just like anyone. Be better than everyone by being the only you. But with that same passion, in that same intensity? Are we willing to fight for people who are different than us? And this is where it came in for me. I did over 30 interviews with people, from a janitor to a former Fortune 500 senior level executive. And I wanted to ask, what did it take to get to authentic success?
I don't want to wake up years from now and realize that I'm not living the life I was supposed to live.
Authentic success are when your actions align with what you say is most important to you.
One of the things that he kind of encapsulates and takes to the next level is calls it a level of action and a level of reaction. He's getting people to actually dig in deep within inside themselves and gives you some breadcrumbs of knowledge to where legitimately after you're done listening to what he has to say, you can go home and take action on what you're talking about doing.
I provide an assortment of different services. One is that I provide customizable keynotes and workshops on a diverse group of topics, as well as one of my mantras is that the information should last longer than I was there. And I do that in two ways. The first way is a one-pager that is given right after the event, and then the second is a 30-day follow-up video that hopefully enhances the information shared so that people will be able to take it to the next level.
Justin presented the Find Your Glasses presentation, and it was fabulous. He gave us an insight to how we can find what we're passionate about and making sure that our core values and our actions correlate and correspond to the things that we say are most important to us.
If I were to tell anybody about Justin, I would say that he is definitely the right person to be able to have come into your organization to be able to speak about the ability to be able to make change, to be a catalyst, to be able to put their heart in the right place.